Welcome back to your free training course on Windows 7. In this video, I will look at how to make changes to the Windows 7 media. Changing the physical media allows you to further customize Windows so when you install Windows, it will already meet your needs. To do this, you need to make changes to the WIM files that Windows 7 uses to store the installation files. WIM files, or Windows Imaging Format, is a file format used by Microsoft to deploy operating systems like Windows 7, Server 2008, and Windows Vista. If you have used imaging software before to deploy Windows, it was probably sector-based. Sector-based imaging takes a copy of the physical sectors on the hard disk so it can be copied to another computer. The problem with this approach is that it is difficult, if not impossible, to make changes to the image once it is created. WIM files, in comparison to sector-based format, are file-based. This means that you can extract as many or as few items from the image file as you want. With Windows 7, each copy of the Windows DVD contains all the editions of Windows 7. These editions, even though they have different features, share many files. Duplicated files are stored in a single instance, reducing the overall size of the DVD. This is why so many different editions of Windows can be installed on the same DVD. Unlike sector-based image formats, WIM files are hardware independent. You can customize your Windows install any way you want, capture the changes, and then deploy them on a different system. The files can even be changed after they have been created and even mounted as a drive letter under Windows Explorer. If you want to add additional files or updates, it is easy to do. Lastly, when you deploy a WIM file, it can be done in a non-destructive way. This means that when you deploy an image onto any existing hard disk, any files that you have that already exist on the hard disk will not be overwritten. To start deploying Windows, you first need to create a reference image. On this reference image, you install updates and additional drivers. You can also customize the install the way you want. For example, you can add shortcuts to the desktop and start menu. If your company has a particular way you want the desktop and start menu, you can change the reference image to look like this. You can also do things like add and disable features. Remember that when you create a reference image, it does not have to be from a clean install of Windows. You may have 100 new laptops you need to deploy. On one of these laptops comes a lot of trial software that you don't want. With imaging technology, you only need to remove the trialware from one computer and then deploy it to the rest of the computers. There's only one problem with this approach. The computer name and the security settings will also be captured and transferred to the new computer. To prevent this from happening, we can use a tool called Sysprep. Sysprep removes the unique settings on a computer, and this allows you to deploy it on many computers. First, Sysprep removes the SIDs. The SIDs, or security identifiers, are unique security codes that are used in account security. If two computers on the same network have the same SIDs, they essentially have the same security accounts. Next, Sysprep removes the device hardware IDs. Essentially, when the computer starts back up, it will use plug and play to re-detect all the hardware on the computer. This allows you to use the same image on many computers, even if the hardware on each computer is different. Lastly, Sysprep removes the computer name and any domain membership. This prevents the problem of deploying two computers on the same network with the same name. Let's have a look at how to set up a computer and then use ImageX and Sysprep to capture it. On this Windows 7 computer, I have installed the MS Office Viewer software and added the shortcuts on the desktop. Now that I have completed the customization for Windows 7, I want to capture this computer so it can be deployed on another computer. To do this, I need to run Sysprep. To do this, I need to open a command prompt from the Start menu and then change to the Sysprep directory, which is located in the System32 folder under the Windows directory. Once I launch the Sysprep executable, I can decide which action I want to perform. The default action is out-of-the-box experience. This will start the computer up with the welcome screen. The user will be asked some initial configuration options. If you select the option System Audit Mode, the computer will boot up in audit mode. In audit mode, the welcome screen is not shown. This gives you the opportunity to make additional changes to the image before you hand the computer over to the user. When the computer boots into audit mode, the default administrator's account will be enabled. You can make changes using this account. When you have finished making the changes, run Sysprep again and select Out of the Box Experience. When the computer reboots, the user will be presented with the Windows Welcome screen and the default administrator account will be disabled. If you're planning to use this image on another computer, you will need to select Generalize. This option will remove the unique settings from the computer, like the security IDs and the computer name. You only need to do this when you are planning on duplicating the image to another computer. If you are switching from audit mode to out-of-the-box mode, you will not need to select this option if it has been selected previously. Lastly, you can choose what to do when Sysprep is finished. Either quit, restart, or shut down. Sysprep does take a few minutes to run. In most cases, I would select shut down or quit. The reasons being that if the computer reboots and you miss the reboot, the system will start up again and the welcome wizard will run. In this case, I am in front of the computer, so I will make sure I don't miss the reboot. Once I press OK, Sysprep will start preparing the computer to boot into out-of-the-box experience. I have put in my Windows PE boot disk in the CD drive to boot off once Sysprep is complete. If you do not have a Windows PE boot disk, you can refer to our previous video on how to create one. Sysprep does take a few minutes to complete, so I will pause the video and return once it has completed and Windows PE has booted. Now that my computer has rebooted into Windows PE, I can map a drive to the server. On this server, I have copied a number of utilities used in imaging. The one I'm going to use in this case is ImageX, which is included with the Windows AIK. Windows will map the drive starting from the last available drive letter, which in this case is Z. From the Z drive, I can now run ImageX with the following parameters. The first is Capture. You can also use ImageX to apply an image that you have already captured. Next, you need to enter in the hard drive you want to capture. In this case, Windows PE has made the Windows drive the D drive. The hard drives you have installed in your system will determine which drive letter it will be, so it is best to check first to confirm which drive Windows PE has made your operating system. Next, I need to enter in the location to save the WIM file. Just to prove a point, I will save the WIM file to the same drive as I am capturing. Unlike sector-based imaging software, ImageX works on the file level, so you can save the WIM file on the same hard disk that you are capturing. After I have finished the capture, I will move the WIM file to the network. The next parameter I can enter in is a name for the image. One WIM file can have many different images. For example, if I wanted to create a new image with MS Office installed rather than the viewers, I could remove the viewers and install MS Office. After I have completed this, I can run Windows PE again and run ImageX again. The next time, I still enter in the same WIM file name, but change the description. Both the images will be saved in the same file. The advantage is that only the changes will be saved with the second image. Any duplicate files found, the second image will reference the first image rather than adding the files to the image again. This makes WIM files very efficient and keeps the size down. After the name, I can add the option Compress. I will set this to Fast. You also have the option Maximum, but this will increase the time taken to capture the image. Finally, I will add the option to verify the image after the capture. Since this image is going to be used on a number of computers, it is a good idea to check to see if there were any problems with the capture before deployment. ImageX will now capture my Windows install. Since I ran Sysprep before the capture, When the image is deployed, the computer will run the welcome wizard and act just like it was just shipped from the factory and taken out of the box. Notice also, by default, certain files are excluded from the capture process. Files in the recycle bin and temporary files have been skipped. Files such as the page file are also skipped, but these will be recreated when Windows starts up for the first time. The image will now be captured and stored on the local hard disk. Before you start deploying this image, you may want to perform maintenance on the image. That is, you may want to add additional drivers and updates to the image. In the next video, I will look at how you can keep your images up to date and increase the lifespan of these images.